In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Julie died with Christ and rose with Christ in glory. May Julie now share in the gift of God's life forever in the kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
Father Rinaldi, Father Johnny, family and friends, thank you for being with us this morning to celebrate the life of a remarkable woman, our mother, Julia. Our mother was born in Reggio Calabria, Italy, and came to the United States in 1948 to attend St. Mary's College in South Bend, where she met her father, who was attending Notre Dame. We moved to Cleveland Heights in 1958 when our father accepted a job here, and our mother never moved from the family home on East Fairfax. She loved the home, and more than that, she loved her neighbors. Her neighbors were always caring and concerned about Mom, and they always looked in on her. Our mother was a woman of faith, and she told me she loved to start her day by going to Mass every morning, where she sat in the first pew. She loved the church and she loved to cook. She showed her love with her cooking. She told me she made pizzas once on a Friday and made an extra one for Father McNulty. The following Monday, when Father McNulty was walking to the altar to say Mass, he stopped at the first pew. He reached under his vestments and handed something to Mom. It was her pizza pan. But maybe give her a new rosary if you like the pizza. why she never watched baseball. She said because there's too much spitting and there's too much anatomical rearranging. I'm going to watch that for 3 hours. Forget about it, Henry. Family was the most important thing to our mother, and she stayed in touch with family outside of Cleveland with phone calls and letters. She shared a letter she received in January from her cousin Joe Samari from South Bend. Joe wrote, "We have come a long way since we were at our grandmother's house on Hill Street. I hope she is proud of the way we turned out. The older I get, I realize that family is so important. It is the connection between the past, the present, and the future. La familia. Our mother was loving, generous, thoughtful, and kind. She was a good mother and the best nanny to her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Thank you for all you've done for us, Mom. I love you."
God of endless ages, from one generation to the next, you have been our refuge and strength. Before the mountains were born or the earth came to be, you are God. Have mercy now on your servant Julie, whose long life was spent in your service. Give her a place in your kingdom, where hope is firm for all who love, and rest is sure for all who serve. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the first reading.
Morning. A reading from the book of Revelation. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, the New Jerusalem, coming out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride to meet her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the book of Job. Job answered and said, "Oh, would that my words were written down, would that they were inscribed in record, that with an iron chisel and with lead they were cut in a rock forever. But as for me, I know that my vindicator lives, and that he will at last stand forth upon the dust, whom I myself shall see, my own eyes, not another's, shall behold him. From my flesh I shall see God. My inmost being is consumed with longing." The words of the Lord.
I'm people would say, where's that woman who sat in Jerusalem? Very unassuming. She'd come from Mass and leave immediately afterwards and went about her daily chores. She was fiercely independent. When COVID struck, I've shared this with the family, I would call the house, finding out how Julie was, but we didn't see her. Finally, I got on the phone and I said, Julie, I've been trying to get a hold of you. How do I get a hold of you? Well, I don't have my answering machine. And they want me always to have that other thing. But it's none of their business where I get. And in many ways, that was her. But her faith was everything about her life. Job is facing sadness. Job, in the first reading, is facing the collapse of his life. But what does he say? I know my Redeemer lives. Like a vindicator, I will put it on a chisel. I'll chisel it to a rock. When she could no longer come to celebrate the Eucharist, it was like a Job-born moment for her. It was her life. When they took the car away, that was even worse. Why? Because she couldn't go about doing what she wanted to do. And she didn't want to be bothered with anyone else. So today, in many ways, is a day to be thankful for her life. The last time I was able to talk to her, I went to the hospice to anoint her, and I go in and I had this crazy mask on, and poor Julie's lying in the bed. She props up and says, I've got COVID. And at that time, you wanted to feel like you had to run out of the place. But in reality, that was her. But before I left, as I thought she was going to fall asleep, all of a sudden she pops up and says, are you going to have my funeral? She was not fearful of death. She really wasn't. Because she did know that her Redeemer lived. She did truly believe that she had a great gift, family and everything. Her children, her grandchildren, her great-grandchildren, they were her life. Her husband, she loved deeply. She loved her two sons, prayerfully with her in the kingdom. She loved them, they were her life. This is the woman of faith. It's sad as it is to have to commend you to the Lord today. In many ways, it's a day we should be thankful that we have people like this, icons like this, who live their faith, not because they have to, not because they have a fear of a God, but that they really know that God is in their life. So I pray that God will be good with her, that God will fulfill everything about her faith that she believes in, that she will find strength God cared for her.
pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us in the hope of the resurrection, especially Julia's husband Tony, her sons Tony and David, and the deceased members of the Samaria and DeBadges families. Grant them an everlasting home in the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, hear our prayers and answer the needs of your people. Send us your Spirit to give us strength and consolation at this time and the loss of your Julie. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept us the sacrifice of our hands, for the praise of the Lord of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Julie, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son, the loving Savior, may find in Christ a merciful judge. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, your faithful, Lord, your faithful life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end.
Oh.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly give you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that the rising of the sun from its setting, your sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously may holding these gifts be brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he sent a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he sent a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Remember your servant, Julia, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that she, united with your Son in death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who die, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. You foresee you are God as you are, we shall be like you through all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. say this command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say it.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let
us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Peace, Lord.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy to be
entered into your presence, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Juliet may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.